You have dared Rahul Gandhi to an open debate and to talk on facts. He's running away from it. What do you have to say?
We have enough evidence, we have enough documentary of evidence from the official record to show that Congress was involved into it. Rajiv Gandhi was himself involved into it. Now Rahul Gandhi has run away from the debate. He has not accepted my challenge for the debate. So I have decided that every day I will ask one question from Rahul Gandhi in public. Let Rahul Gandhi answer that question. That will clearly prove the involvement of Congress Party, involvement of Rajiv Gandhi.
And Mr. Phoolka, why is it that the Congress Party is so blatantly trying to defend Rahul Gandhi and they are giving arguments like he was only a teenager at that time, he cannot be held responsible? Fact remains that he is the president of the Congress Party and he is responsible for what he says.
No, we are not saying that Rahul Gandhi is personally responsible for it as a president of Congress Party. And when Rahul Gandhi chose to espouse the cause of those guilty leaders, then he is answerable to it. How can
exactly
he run away from answering?
He is responsible for his
statements.
That
Rahul Gandhi was 13. Then why is he giving? Then Rahul Gandhi should say, I was only 13, I do not know. Then why is he espousing their cause? No Congress leader was involved, the Congress was not involved. Why is he espousing their cause?
But Mr. Phoolka, how do you plan to take this forward considering how angry the entire Sikh community is and this whole case that has been going on for decades now? You seek justice, the entire Sikh community seeks justice. How do you plan to take this forward?
Well, you see, not only the Sikh community, the whole of the civil society, the whole all of those people who want peace in the country, they are angry with this. Now, like I told you, that Rahul Gandhi has run away from the debate. He is not prepared to answer the question. So I will ask him the publicly. Now it is for you people, it is for the media now to pin him down and ask him to reply to those questions. Let him answer those questions, which the Congress has been running away till now for all these 34 years. They have no answer to those questions. From today onwards, I will start up asking those questions.
And Mr. Phoolka, we just saw that video that BJP had tweeted where Rahul Gandhi had admitted to Arnab Goswami that the Congress was very much involved. He clearly said that certain congressmen had a role in the 1984 riots. Then why is he tracking back from his statement now?
Obviously under pressure from those leaders who are involved, because they are too powerful in Congress. The Kamal Nath, Jagdish Chaitra, Sajjan Kumar, these people are powerful, and because they have their defense that we did it because the Rajiv Gandhi asked us. They did it for the party. So obviously, under pressure from those very people that they did it for the party, the party has to save them now. This is under that pressure that Rahul Gandhi is now backing out from his statement.
And what is the face that the Congress is left with now? You have challenged him to an open debate. You think he's going to come forward? You think this is the right way to go about it?
No, he's not coming forward. He's not coming forward. This is obvious. He's not coming forward. So let the media ask him those questions. Let him answer those questions.
And you think you've done the right thing by challenging him?
No, that is true, because he is the one who is espousing the cause. He is the one who is saying the Congress is not involved. So, I am right in challenging him. And I have my right to challenge him to come and answer those questions which we have, to meet that documents and the proof which we have of the involvement of Congress and Rajiv Gandhi.
And Mr. Phoolka, if you're given a choice, or rather an option, to debate with some other Congress person, who would that be? And would you be wanting to go ahead with that debate?
Yes, definitely. I've said let Rahul Gandhi nominate any of his general secretaries. I've said so. I know handicap of Rahul Gandhi. I know he probably will not be able to debate. So giving him that benefit, that's the reason I have said that, and he can nominate any of his general secretaries, I am prepared to debate. with that person.
So that means if Congress is willing... So that means if Congress is willing to debate with you tonight, you will go ahead on that debate.
Definitely, 100%.
Right, Mr. Phoolka, continue talking to us, sir, because this is very important, especially after how Rahul Gandhi's lie has been exposed. He had admitted very clearly that congressmen were involved. Now he's tracking back from his statement. And just see the way Congress is defending him. We have the former finance minister, the Punjab CM, who are giving arguments like he was a teenager then. How can you hold him responsible? Fair enough for that. But even these arguments hold any grounds? What do you have to say about that?
No, no. You see that these people, obviously, they are under Rahul Gandhi. So they are out to defend him. Then please tell these people to go and advise Rahul Gandhi that when this question is answered about the 84 involvement, he should simply say, I was 13 years, I was in the school, I don't know anything. Then if he says so, we have no difficulty. We will not ask the questions from him. But when he claims that none of the Congress leaders, the Congress is not involved, so obviously then he has to answer.
So right now all you
then
want
this
him...
13-year argument is just absurd.
So right now all you want is Rahul Gandhi to tender an apology. Otherwise, you're not going to let this go like this. He should come out and either debate
No, not only apology. Apology and punishment, both have a play in their own fields. Punishment to guilty, the law of the land. We say implement the law of the land. This is the duty of the government to punish anyone whosoever indulges into the offense like heinous offense like murder. Now here thousands of murder have taken place. It is the duty of the government. It was the duty of the Rajiv Gandhi government to trace that who has committed that murder. Even when a blind murder takes place, it's the government and the government machinery and the police. They trace who has killed and then secure the punishment. Here it is the open daylight and the openly on the roads. The six were killed, thousands of six were killed. Now this was the duty of the government to trace them, to punish them. It's the law of the land. We want the law of the land should be upheld. Not only apology, the punishment.
And how is Rahul Gandhi even thinking that he's going to get away from this? Because it's not like he is not aware of the facts. It's not like he is not aware of the investigation that has been happening all these years. Then, and he is a PM aspirant that we are talking about. How can he go around to make such a statement?
So that is most surprising. That's most shocking. This kind of a statement. And then running away from answering the questions. Last night also on your TV, I have given my commitment to the Congress spokesperson, each and everything. When they say, why you have come out after 34 years? Why you didn't ask it earlier? I say, official record. Each and every question I will ask from the official record. Nothing I will take out from my own pocket. It is all from the official record and the record of the government. And the most of the time the government has been of Congress. And most of these, this record and the documents are there during the Congress government time. But unfortunately, the government, instead of acting on it, trying to suppress it. That is the unfortunate part. The Congress has always been trying to do so.
Mr. Phoolka, thank you so much for talking to Republic, and we look forward to you joining the debate tonight with Arnab Goswami, where all these questions will come once again and we see what the Congress has to say on this.